Well, I think I'm gonna go if you two are gonna just sit around and suck each other's dicks.
Noah Baumbach is often recognized as a great screenwriter. He writes dialogue that is simultaneously realistic but also dramatic. But good dialogue only gets you so far. Thankfully, Baumbach can also handle the rest, and he handles the rest brilliantly in Marriage Story. In this scene from Marriage Story, Scarlett Johansson plays actor Nicole as she nervously approaches the cunning lawyer Nora to discuss her separation from theatre director Charlie. For context, Charlie and Nicole had agreed not to use lawyers, but Nicole was encouraged by a new colleague to seek out Nora anyway.
She saved my life.
So Nicole agrees to meet with Nora, but because of her no lawyer agreement with Charlie, she is extremely tentative about the process and is doing it to fill an emotional need rather than a cognitive desire to be represented in court. Nora knows this and completely takes advantage of her. In this scene, Nora uses Nicole's pain to gain power, and we are shown just how powerless Nicole has been and is becoming. The scene starts with an already tall Laura Dern, made even taller with these incredible heels, saying this.
Sorry, I look so schleppy. I had an event at my kid's school.
Now, Nora looks the furthest thing from schleppy here. She's in tight designer jeans, a YSL blazer, red pumps, and full makeup. So immediately we know that Nora likes to lie and deceive. And Nicole knows it too. Notice how, as soon as Nora says she looks schleppy, the editor cuts to Nicole, who looks at her own more comfortable outfit, gets self-conscious, and recognizes Nora to be that slippery personality. So then Nora says,
"Let me get this out of the way. I think you're a wonderful actress."
Thank you.
Nicole doesn't see this compliment as being truthful because she has already recognized the kind of person that Nora is. So her response is a small but polite thank you. But watch, Nora has come prepared.
"I loved All Over the Girl, but the theater stuff too."
"You saw the theater stuff?"
All Over the Girl was Nicole's breakout movie, and it's famous for this. But after that movie, Nicole went into theater, and that's where she met Charlie. Now, all of this was introduced way earlier in the movie, but here, Baumbach also makes a clever callback to the last scene just 1 minute ago, where we were reminded of how most people treat Nicole as a pair of tits.
"Or something. You are fucking hot in that movie."
"Carol,
fuck it, I speak my mind."
"We're not allowing our son to see us."
"Because you show your tits."
"Carol." Yeah.
So this is a pain point for Nicole. She wants to feel appreciated. This is true for her career, where she is now going back to Hollywood to try and become a bigger star, and it is also true for her relationship with Charlie. So even though Nicole knows that Nora is slippery, she wants more than anything to feel appreciated, and as soon as she gets complimented on her theatre work, she lets her guard down.
"You saw the theatre stuff?"
Nora keeps up the compliments just to really abuse that pain point.
"You are awesome."
And now Nora asks the question she already knows the answer to.
"How are you doing?"
"Oh, honey."
So grabbing the conveniently placed tissues and climbing onto the sofa next to her, Nora starts to invade Nicole's physical space on the couch. And now Nora wants Nicole to gain confidence in herself. This way, Nicole has the motivation to get what she wants and, by extension, get representation in court and hire Nora. So Nora spends some time really building up her confidence.
"What you're doing is an act of hope. You understand that?"
And now Nora prompts Nicole to start talking about the relationship from the beginning.
"Why don't you start at the beginning, wherever that is for you?"
"I was engaged to Ben."
Nora is an audience surrogate here. A character like Harry Potter who asks the same question an audience would so that the audience can get all the backstory without it being a huge information dump. And here, Baumbach cleverly converts this plot summary of the relationship into an emotional summary of the relationship. On the page, this scene looks mostly like exposition. It's a monologue, and so you could film it just by pointing a camera at Nicole and calling action. But as director, Baumbach uses creative blocking, the physical movement and arrangement of actors within the space, to really elevate the scene from the page and show just how powerless Nicole is in this situation. Thanks in part to Nora's previous confidence boosts and her well-prepared tea trap.
"Oh,
This tea is delicious,
isn't it?
Nicole starts telling the story with confidence. She composes herself and starts moving, completing actions like blowing her nose, applying lip balm, and getting rid of her tears in the bathroom to show how she has regained composure. It's a clever way to visualize how Nicole felt at the beginning of her relationship with Charlie, happy and confident. But then the cookie trap appears and we are reminded again of how Nora is in control.
I learned that it was. These cookies are really great too.
I'll send you home with some.
Notice that Nora stays still the whole time. She knows that the relationship didn't last, and therefore Nicole's composure also won't last. She stays on the sofa ready for Nicole to break down. So when Nicole starts to become exasperated again, she rises from her seat and falls back to Nora.
And then I got pregnant.
And when she talks about being trapped by the pregnancy, the camera slowly zooms in, physically entrapping her in the corner of the room. At the end of the story, Nora sympathetically hugs Nicole, and now Nicole is both physically and symbolically in Nora's grip. Nicole can't see it, but Baumbach clearly shows us the fakeness of Nora's sympathy face, and when combined with her exaggerated hand rubbing, we really get the sense that Nora has made her catch hook, line, and sinker.
The fucking asshole.
And if you've been paying attention, Nora is so in control of Nicole's emotions and the situation that she's even mapped out the scene's final destination in the photograph above her. Despite how personal she has made the conversation feel, Nora has manipulated Nicole like she would any and every other client, by using their pain to gain power. And the abuse of pain is prevalent throughout the film. This is what the process of the trial does. It takes their happy memories,
sorry, I drank too much wine,
and it turns them into painful memories.
Nicole about her alcohol consumption in the evenings.
What?
She confided in Charlie one night recently, having just carried Henry to bed, that she was having trouble standing while walking down the staircase.
So as the film progresses, each partner only sees the other as pain.
People used to tell me that you were too selfish to be a great artist, and I used to defend you. They were absolutely right.
All your best acting is behind you. You're back to being a hack.
And by the end of the film, what was once the greatest love becomes the greatest pain.
He's very clear about what he wants, unlike me, who can't always tell. I fell in love with him 2 seconds after I saw him.
I love this film. When I rewatched it for this video, I laughed like crazy and I cried myself to death. I love this film so much that last year I even made this huge 3x4 foot oil painting of it. I think that too often YouTubers will cover the content of a film vaguely as a whole, and I really wanted to go in depth and dive into a scene to really show how brilliant the filmmaking at hand is. So in today's YouTube video, I only really had the time to talk about one scene in depth. I could talk about the film for hours, but I just don't have the views or subscribers to really back that kind of effort up right now. So if you could help in any way, that would be greatly appreciated. And if you want to know what film or show I'm reviewing before I upload, make sure to follow me on Instagram and Twitter, where I'll let you know in advance so that you can be caught up by the time my video comes out. With that said, thank you very much for watching, and I will see you next time. Thank you.